Welcome back to the big program. In addition to everything else that's going on in the show tonight, Tom Hanks is here, and you'll meet him in just a couple of minutes. You know, Paul, there is no spring training so far this year. No spring training for baseball teams. As I understand it, the major league teams, the owners, have locked the camps, thereby shutting the players out of the facilities.
That's a lockout.
Yeah, a lockout, because some kind of a labor deal. And since there is that lockout, we've decided that if players wanted to, they could come up here and train in our hallway.
How nice.
And a couple have taken us up on that offer tonight in our hallway, right out here on the sixth floor. From the California Angels, we have Mark Langston. There he is right there, heating him up. And he's playing catch tonight with Scott Bradley from the Seattle Mariners. So they'll be out there. Mark, can you hear me?
Yeah, Dave.
Mark?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, next time that elevator door opens up, load one in there, okay?
We're looking for a crowded one.
Just let me know when it opens up. I'd like to see that.
Okay.
All right. And put some heat on it.
All right.
All right. Thank you very much. Our first guest tonight is, you know, maybe I can go out there and knock some a little later. Oh, by the way, I forgot to tell him. Hey, guys. No, hey, listen. No pepper, okay?
There's one.
Thank you. Oh, there. Dust. Yeah. One more. Try it once more, quick.
Look out. Oh. Heads up. Yeah. Come on, we're trying to work out here.
Oh, my God. Lawsuit. I can see that coming up. Sixth Avenue, $8 million, jammed index finger. Our first guest is an old friend of ours, and he has another brand new motion picture coming out. It's entitled Joe Versus the Volcano, and I believe it opens across the country next week. Ladies and gentlemen, here he is, the one, the only, Tom Hanks. Thanks for being here, and also thanks for being on our anniversary show. That was a lot of fun. You did a great job.
Well, the anniversary show, that was a big thing for me, too, because you've had me on the show now, I think, like 60 times. Mm-hmm. Through thick and thin. You have really meant a lot to my career, Dave.
Thank you.
You had me here for Dragnet, and I want to thank you for that. All those that couple of leads.
Right. I do remember Dragnet.
But I like coming on your show because you pay me.
That's right.
With the anniversary show, I cleared $1.2 million total
from
your show. Yes.
So that's the total earnings for your appearances.
I think I'm up now to about $17,000 per appearance on your show. And I did,
and this is all scale.
Well, yes. Yeah. Well,
I have two questions I need to ask you, and then we can go on to other matters. I understand you were off on a vacation and you injured yourself.
Yes, I did.
Yeah. Now, you were off skiing.
I was skiing.
Now, when did you do that? Because when I saw you in California, you looked fine.
Well, no, it was just before the New Year. Mm-hmm. I was a Christmas New Year.
Right. Big holiday.
I was in Utah, right? Which is usually a very safe place to ski, Dave.
Really?
Yes. Well, here's what happened. We were going to lunch, and I was skiing fast, but very much in control. I'm a half decent skier.
Are you an accomplished skier?
I am probably what you would call an intermediate advanced skier.
Right.
I can handle the sleds, as we call them.
Yeah.
We were at the top of one hill, and we said, hey, let's go to lunch. Let's go to the lodge and have lunch.
Worked
okay, so we're all booking down there. And I was going fast, Dave, but I was skiing in control. And I'm veering off to the side, and I'm skiing along fine. I need to get all the way over there to head over to lodge. And just out of the corner of my eye, I see a kid coming more or less the opposite way.
Right.
And in my mind, of course, I said, kid! And sure enough, bang, I hit that. He folded up
You drilled the kid.
I drilled the kid. His name was Peter. He was not hurt. He was very apologetic. I felt so good that I didn't hurt
him. He was not injured. Thank goodness for that.
And I was not hurt by hitting the kid. I wasn't hurt by hitting him. But after I hit him and kind of like started careening down the slope, and what I saw coming at me was like trees like this.
Yeah.
Trees were coming at me like this.
Large trees, evergreen trees.
A huge clump of
not big saplings, but big
pine trees.
Thickly trunked trees.
Like, and I was kind of going around like this, and these trees are, and in my mind, of course, I'm thinking, trees!
Yeah.
And I hit one on my shin and kind of went around, but I came to rest against another tree. Mm-hmm. I didn't hit the last tree. I just kind of came to rest against this last tree. But I'm folded up around this tree, kind of like
it. It wasn't one of those make-a-wish deals, was
no,
it?
No, it wasn't. And my skis are off, and I feel pain in my legs, which I'm thinking is
both
good.
Legs?
No,
both?
Just one. But I think, it's good I feel pain
still
in my legs.
Feeling, yeah.
Because if I don't feel anything, then my legs are back there.
Mm.
But I'm laying there for a few seconds, realizing that I can't walk. I'm going to need to use one of the cameras.
Sure, which
cameras?
Yourself. We have four. Pick
I'll
one.
I'll use this one.
Okay.
Or I'll use this one. And I suddenly I see this. You okay, Tom? Tom, you all right? Your leg okay, Tom? Do we have time for this?
Yeah, we have plenty of time.
I was hurt very badly, and I couldn't feel my leg. And eventually the ski patrol guys came. These guys are real experts at all this. They deal with this 15 times an hour.
Yeah. How long after you hit the tree did they come and attend to you?
2.5 hours. Yeah. They came very quickly.
They were also at lunch.
They were only about 15 minutes away. But I said, now, obviously, I'm going to have to be ridden down in those toboggan things that you always see. You go like this when you see people going down in the toboggan.
Yeah.
Oh, look, the guy's going down in a toboggan.
And you start shaking
and
your head.
In my mind, all I can think of is toboggan. That's all I want. And I'm thinking that they're gonna take me down, the ski patrol experts. And, of course, I'll ride down like this with my head at the top of the toboggan.
Yeah.
No, they put me in backwards, Dave. And my head was at the bottom of the toboggan. And my feet were pointed
up. So your head is just kind of hitting the snow as you go?
No, well, it's like, they say, the snow from the guy's skis were coming up in my face.
Now, why did they do that?
I have this neck brace on because they found me like this.
Yeah.
And I think I've wrenched my back.
But why did they load you in backwards?
Because I couldn't feel my toes.
Oh, really?
They said, can you feel your toes?
Uh-huh.
And I said, no. And they say, well, you might have broken it. I said, no, I think it's just because they're in ski boots.
Yeah.
I can hardly move that one thing.
But if you can't feel your toes, they load you in backwards.
That's a very serious thing if they can't feel
Oh, no,
your toes.
The whole thing is very serious.
And they asked, did your bindings release?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I know.
Yeah.
well, where are the skis? Yeah. You know?
Ask
are
the
they
kid.
Still attached?
Ask the kid if they
Peter
release.
Has them, yeah, as he's going down.
So now, let's finish this up here. But then you go. And what was the extent of the damage?
Well,
you ligament damage?
No,
did you break anything?
If I had hit that kid and then those trees a little higher, I would have been in trouble. But it hit right here, and essentially my leg just swelled up to about the size of a canned ham.
Mm-hmm.
Just
big,
like that big.
Yeah.
And I couldn't walk for quite some time.
But you're all right now.
I'm fine, and
would
my ligament.
Would you go back skiing again?
In a minute next year.
Really?
Yeah, sure.
In a minute next year. And was it also a little bit compounded by the fact that everybody's saying, "Oh, it's Tom Hanks"?
Yes, it made. Yeah, they had. Guys from the Salt Lake television affiliates were trying to, like, storming the Park City Health Clinic there.
Yeah.
To get what? Footage?
Yeah.
I couldn't understand.
All right, and when we come back, we'll talk about your hair when we come back.
No.
Yeah, okay. Are those guys still playing ball in the hallway? A kid in that elevator. Paul, seriously, this is the best school dance we've ever had.
That was a special request.
Yeah,
little GTO
that,
by the
GTOs, right?
Oh, little GTO by Ronnie and the Daytonas.
Oh, I'm sorry. And what are they doing lately? You know?
I think one is an executive and the other one's...
And that was your request?
Yes.
Any significance there?
I just dig car and surfing songs.
Yeah. All right. Now...
I'm a white boy.
Let me ask you about the... Let me ask you about the hat and the hair, just quickly.
Oh,
we got to talk about
it. I'm experimenting
Let's
with
just
like
see it,
stuff.
Quickly.
Oh, it just looks terrible.
Not bad. Look at that.
Look like Elvis Presley's kissing cousin, or my own evil twin. I'm not sure which I look.
But the purpose of that is
It's for Bonfire. I'm trying around some stuff.
Talk a little bit about this movie. I mentioned it. We chatted about it before the show. But this is like a big deal.
Yeah. It mostly stems from Thomas Wolfe's books. You know, it's a very popular novel.
Yeah.
It kind of brought literature back to segments of America who hadn't really thought about it.
And you're in the starring role.
Well, I'm
you're
Sherman.
The guy who you're
I'm Sherman McCoy.
Yeah.
And myself and Bruce. Bruce Willis kind of, we have a, it's kind of a dual story.
Who else is in the cast?
Melanie Griffith is in the cast so far. Man. And that's all I know of so far.
So this is going to be your blockbuster. Certified blockbuster.
Well, I mean, you know, Brian De Palma is directing it. And, you know, we've had talks about it. We said if we do it right, you know, it could be as good as Gone with the Wind. If we do it wrong, it'll be as good as, say, The Fountainhead or something.
And how does he feel about the hair so far? Does he like the hair?
Yeah.
Did you do that yourself?
We're goofing around. We have a long time before we start.
Yeah.
So.
Right.
Oh, I did it myself with a Tony Home.
I don't know. One rainy day, you and your wife go down to the store.
And, you know, it's with streaks and tips, yeah. You know, and trying various.
I don't know. Maybe
see,
you
let's
did.
See, amber straw. Let's try that. See how that comes through.
How do you like being married? You've been married now, what?
Oh, great. Yeah. I've been married to Rita for almost 2 years.
Yeah, you enjoying married life?
Oh, it's wonderful.
Yeah.
It's wonderful.
And a family soon?
I have two kids already, and Rita and I, we're having our first baby together in the late summertime.
Well, congratulations.
We can't, thank you. The baby's due in late summer, and we can't buy any clothes for the baby yet, because none of them will fit, because the baby's only that big.
Yeah, I know.
It's perfect sense. It's a new father's joke.
Oh, is it really?
My baby's only that big. See?
Yeah, how could you shop? And baseball, are you disappointed about the big lockout?
Well, yeah. Well, I was involved in organized baseball for
That's
a while.
Right. I remember that.
I sold peanuts and soda at Oakland A's games at the Oakland Coliseum.
How old were you when you did that?
I was 14 years old.
Was that?
I joined the union to go off and do that.
Well, was that at the same time the best experience for a kid and maybe a tough experience for a kid?
It was kind of exciting to have, you know, to be able to walk home with $25 in my pocket, you know, from the game.
Sure.
But then I'd be sitting on the bus and I would get robbed on the way home.
Yeah.
That was kind of a guy was sitting there and he says, if you don't give me $5 now, I'm going to jump you when the bus stops, and then I'm going to get all of it.
Yeah.
So why don't you just give me $5 now?
Now, how did he know you had that kind of dough on you?
I'm not really sure, but I for some reason he knew I was a vendor, and maybe the black pants and the white shirt and that plastic bow tie
gave
it away.
You fit
really
the profile
sure.
of vendor.
Maybe. He just said, I bet you're a vendor.
So, in the meantime, before you go back to work on this, you having vacations anymore, or are you just healing up, or what are you doing?
Well, no. Well, actually, I was...
Oh, tell me about Joe and the Volcano. I'm sorry.
Oh, well, yes, Joe and the Volcano. It opens next week.
Yeah. Now, what's that about?
Meg Ryan. It's a kind of existential adventure with... It's about a guy who has a terrible job, not like yours, who finds out that... I don't know why I said it.
Yeah, I don't know why you said that either.
You have a good job.
Yeah, I thought so. Thanks.
Joe Banks finds out he has a...
I don't have to dye my hair or anything, but it's...
I had to wear a wig in Joe. That was kind of fun.
Anyway, he finds out
he's going to die from a brain cloud, and so then takes a job to jump into a volcano to appease a volcano god that a bunch of islanders believe in. And it's an amazing saga of him getting there, discovering who he is once again, and reclaiming his soul.
Turn out nicely? You happy with it?
Oh, yeah, I think so. It's a very unique, very unusual movie.
Entertaining? Funny?
Oh, yes.
Sad?
All that. Sad.
Make you laugh?
Meg Ryan is in it, so that's a...
Make you cry?
Kiss your $7 goodbye. Yeah.
Can we go out and hit a couple of balls off Langston or not? We don't have time, do we?
Dang.
Okay, we'll be right back. Come on, let's run out there and take a couple of swings. We'll be right back.